Alright, so I have two nice antelope here that I can show you guys how to clean. Me and my dad both shot these. They're two really nice antelope. So anyway, I'm just going to show you guys how to clean these, and let's get started. So the first thing we're going to do is we are going to take the hair off these. So I'm just going to slit down here towards the nose, and I'm just going to peel it back and start carving down each side until I get the skin totally off. That's the easiest way to do it, I think. So anyway, here's one. I've just finished this one now. And as you can see, it looks real nice. That one got shot. I accidentally shot that one in the face. Now I just have to do this one to do, so I'll do that one quick and I'll show you guys what it looks like.
Alright, so got one of these skinned. This one's skinned too. See, way to skin an animal. Like that, falls off, and you have it. Anyway, we'll throw them in a pile. Here they both are. Two nice bucks. Anyway, now I'm gonna take the eyeballs out, tongue, lower jaw. Actually, I don't even need to take the tongue out. So I'll just take both the eyeballs out, lower jaw, and then we'll get to boiling.
A dream is like a river, ever changing as it flows. And a dreamer's just a vessel that must follow where it goes. Trying to learn from what's behind you and never knowing what's in store makes each day a constant battle just to stay between the shores. And I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry, like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Too many times we stand beside and let the water slip away, till what we put off till tomorrow has now become today. So don't you sit up on the shoreline and say you're satisfied. Choose to chance the rapids and dare to dance the tide. Yes, I will sail my vessel.
Alright, so get ready for mounting these before we boil them. We're gonna set this up the angle that we want it hung up on the wall. Take a saw and saw straight down through this bone right about in here, right between the behind the horns. That way we can get that brain out and all that stuff too. It'll just make it easier to clean and hang up.
With the good Lord as my captain, I can make it through them all. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry, like a bird upon the wind. These waters are my sky. I'll never reach my destination if I never try. So I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Yes, I will sail my vessel till the river runs dry. Till the river runs dry.
So I got this sawed off, got the brains out of each side. This side I'll just chuck, because I won't need that. Put that in there. But anyway, there we have it, both of them. There's the brains in there for tanning hides with. Anyway, now we're gonna take them outside and we'll start the boiling. Alright, so they've been sitting in this boil for around 10 minutes. So now I'm going to pull them out one at a time and try to pop those sheets off of the horns. I'm going to just pop those off, throw them on a bag over here, and then we'll check to see if they're done. And if they are not done yet, we'll throw them back in there for a little while. And so we'll pull these out, pop the sheets off, and then we'll throw them in there and keep them boiling. For right now, I'll show you guys how to pop those sheets off and let's get to work. Thank you. tips of these are done now. As you can see, it is split on top of the nose. So now we're just gonna take a razor blade and this stuff. Since you pop the horns off, it's got all the stuff underneath of it. We're gonna slice up here and we're just gonna peel all that off. That way we don't have to try to pressure wash that off. So anyway, we'll take that off, set up the pressure washer, get down there, we'll start washing. Alright, so I just stuck them back in upside down. That way I can sort of boil off that tissue that was underneath the horn, make it easier to get it off. So I'm gonna let that sit in there for a little while and then I'll pull it out, tear that stuff off, and then we'll get to spraying. Of stuff out that's up in the nose and stuff, because there's a lot of junk up in there. But got that one. This is the one where the bullet went through, so, but he still looks pretty good. Anyway, there they both are. I'm gonna be using this glue. That's what I'm going to be using. I have to open up a new one because this was my open one. Sort of like silly putty. Anyway, so I'll take these off, squirt some of this stuff down inside the sheath, then I'll be looking at a picture about how they were, because see, they move quite a bit, so I'll have to get it just perfect to where they were before. Stuff like that. So anyway, I'll open this up, squirt some down in there, and we'll set them where they need to be, and I'll show you guys what they look like. All right, so I got these put where I want them to. I don't know if you can see that all that well, but anyway, I put the stuff in. Still drying. They look pretty good. See, looks pretty nice. There's a few open gaps down here at the bottom, but I think I'll just leave those. See, especially on this one. But anyway, I think I'll just leave it. So anyway, we'll let that dry and then I'll show you guys what they look like. Alright, so I said I was just going to leave these gaps in here, but they are quite big, so I think I'm going to try to fill those in, and maybe try to fill in some of these cracks here and there, just a little bit, just to make it look nicer. So I'm just going to be trying this. It's just regular caulk, but anyway, these are nice and secured on now, won't come off. So anyway, I'm going to caulk these up, let that dry, and then I'll show you guys what it looks like. Alright, so these are done now. As you can see, real nice, all clean. This is a bit more worse than this one, but I filled in underneath the horns. There's no holes in there. Got it looking nice. Okay. There's how to clean the antelope skull. There we go, and I'll see you on the next one.
I was born on the top of the mountainside. The view on the top was big and wide. And my daddy used to show me how to hunt. Real people come hunting from miles around. Some are going on the way to town. They come from the valley to the top of the old pine tree. I'm a hunting man. I'm a hunting man. Everybody get together anytime we can. I'm a hunting man, fishing. I'm a hunting man.